What do you have to say to your supporters?
Mostly what I have to say is, like, you know, this has been a reflective time for me. I'm very grateful for all the people shown support for me. It's very humbling, honestly. And so I'm thankful for them, but I'm happy to be back. So I'll be back Monday.
Oh, that's great.
Yeah, I'll be back Monday. It'll be great. And yeah, I mean, I'm just concentrating more on moving forward. So,
I mean, people were worried you might be leaving ESPN. Is that any point? No. You've worked it all out? And
yeah, look, me and ESPN are fine. And it's just like, I know it's great conjecture to think about what might happen, but like, we're fine. We're in a good place. And I'm happy to be back at the network. And so, yeah, like, I don't have much to say beyond that.
Well, so what about Twitter? You coming back to Twitter? We miss you.
Oh, absolutely.
Oh, yeah?
Coming
okay.
back to Twitter. Look, I want people to understand this. Like, there was never any restrictions placed on me about
oh, really?
Twitter.
Okay.
Never. So
nothing in your contract forbidding
no,
you from...
nothing. And so I'll be back on Twitter, and I'll be my usual self.
But do you feel that you were treated fairly by the network?
So here's how this works, is that... it doesn't really matter what I think. I think, you know, as
well, it matters to us.
No, it matters to people. But like, here's the reality: it's like ESPN acted what they felt was right, and you know, I don't have any argument or quibble with that. I would tell people absolutely after my Donald Trump tweets, I deserve that suspension. I deserved it. Like,
wow.
Absolutely. Like, I violated the policy. I deserve that suspension. You know, going forward, like, we'll be in a good, healthy place. It'll be fine. And
yeah, so
I'm looking forward to it. As I said, like, the only thing I ever apologize for is, like, I put ESPN in a bad spot. I'll never take back what I said.
Wow. All right.
So I put them in a bad spot. And, yeah, that's the truth of it. I regret the position I put them in. I regret a lot of the people I work with, the position we put our show in. I'll never take back what I said. So you can take that to mean what it means.
Okay. She said she violated, she deserved it. And say because she violated ESPN protocol. Well, so did Michelle Beadle, and no type of suspension or nothing never happened to her. But then again, look like this, you know. Like, you know, for the record, let me say something right, like quick. I never like to hear about anybody losing their job or their career over some stupid stuff. But at the same time,
what do you have to say to your supporters?
Sorry about that. At the same time, as far as I'm concerned with Jamil Hill, you know, she could bite a big one as far as I'm concerned. Because, you know, as all she doing did in this interview here, all she did, she just sucking up the master and, you know, had to do PR damage control. That's the reason why she was suspended 2 weeks, so that way she can get her shit straight. And, you know, this was choreographed. This is what ESPN told her to say and make them put in a good light. Shoot. But see, because the next step right now, you know, the next step, she gone might be end up being out the door. Watch what I tell you. I give you before the end of this year that she'll probably be over there at Fox Sports. Because like I said, like the only cast that supported her, these simps and all that. Like the first time when she, you know, went up against Tangerine and Tangerine came after, yeah. A lot of those brothers stepped up to the plate and defended them, myself included. I do not deny that. But then she turns right back around and does a fucking 180 and co-signed that asinine article from the Griot, I think the Griot or the Root, but it was from Very Smart Brothers by that queer coon, Damon Young, that black man of the new, straight black man of the new white man and all that stuff song. And she co-signed it by retweeting it. So, and I, you know, I told people a while back, because I was, even when I came out and defended her, I also said at the same time, I said, man, look here, don't trust this gal. I showed y'all what she said, how she caped up for Christian Leahy against LeVar Ball, how she went up against Ray Rice. Myself and Herb Griffin had said that, as well as several others. So what I'm saying right here, she ain't doing nothing but sucking back up the master. That's all she is. You know, cooling for compensation. You know, because she constantly also throw black men under the bus. Here you got a chick who's 41 years old, not married, no kids, don't have a man. Her ideal mate would have to be one of the athletes. Would have to be one of the athletes that they interview. And they've overpassed her. But at the same time, she get out here and she throw shade at brothers. So, you know, like I said, when she got this time for the suspension, like I said, man, look, so what? Let's keep it moving. The brothers are going to sit this one out. So as far as I'm concerned, because I knew she was going to do this, she just did, what you just did is the same thing. It's the same thing. It's the same thing. Same thing that Quarterfro head Stephen A. Snitch did when he was on the suspension. Came back out and it's going to be like a public apology, blah, 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 this and that. You know. But, you know, who cares if she comes back anyway, though? So, you know, they finna pull Sports Center 6 anyway. ESPN's losing ratings. That's why she did that shit. But anyway, you know how I said about this. You go back to one of my videos when I told everybody I warned about Jemele Hill. So, you know, fuck her. She made a bed, let her lie. Let me know what y'all think about this in the comment section. Subscribe, share. Make sure you click the notification bell. So therefore, when I upload new videos, y'all can...